What is going on, guys? This is Luke, and in today's video, we'll be discussing a topic that is very near and dear to my heart, which is keyframe interpolation and the use of the keyframe graph editor. I'll mainly be linking these concepts of keyframe interpolation to motion graphics, but the same will apply to other areas such as editing and compositing. So there's a couple of different terms I mentioned: keyframing, interpolation, and the keyframe graph editor. So let's take a minute to refresh your memory or enlighten you and make sure that we're all on the same page. Keyframing is when you generate an animation by setting a start and end point to a property or an effect over time. For the purpose of this video, I'm going to assume that you already know what keyframing is, why we do it, and how to do it. We're going to be taking that concept of keyframing to the next level today with interpolation. So what is interpolation? Well, it's pretty much a way of filling in the frames between keyframes. In most cases, you're going to be making the animation look less linear, more dynamic, more stylized, and a little bit more natural. You use something called the keyframe graph editor to customize default interpolation keyframes to achieve your desired look. So hopefully you've seen some of the animations playing on the screen by now. I use keyframe interpolation in these examples to get a less stale and a more natural look to the animations. Let's take a look at this simple animation of a ball bouncing. With these two examples, you have one that uses a default linear keyframe, whereas the other uses a smooth in and smooth out keyframe interpolation. Now, rhetorically speaking, which one looks more realistic or natural? Well, the linear one has the same speed and rate during the whole animation, but the interpolated animation has acceleration and deceleration, which gives it a more natural appearance. I'd say that the use of interpolation can really change your animations from looking very novice and very beginner-like to looking very professional very easily. I see a lot of HitFilm users in particular who make videos and even tutorials on keyframing who don't know that keyframing interpolation exists. So I'll bore you guys with a little bit of technicalities before I show you how to actually interpolate these keyframes. It's one thing to know that it exists, but you should actually understand the concept so that you can utilize different interpolation properties properly. Misusing interpolation keyframes can really mess up your animation and make it appear unusual. In HitFilm, there are five main types of keyframes: linear, smooth, smooth in, smooth out, and constant. With linear, the change from one keyframe to the next is constant. It's going the exact same rate the whole time. The motion of the element starts and finishes the exact same speed. And if you take a look at that graph, and yes, that is the quote-unquote keyframe graph editor, the x-axis is representing time and the y-axis is showing the transform properties. In this case, that transform property is position. Looking back at that graph editor, you'll notice that there's a straight linear line or a linear slope. And this is the default keyframe option, but really it's not a natural movement and it has a sudden start and a sudden stop. So let's take a look into the smooth in and smooth out keyframe options. Smooth in and smooth out are two different types, as I mentioned before, and the location that you put either of these keyframes will allow you to achieve an acceleration or a deceleration motion to your animation. Let's look into smooth keyframes. And once again, I encourage you to take a look at that graph and you'll see that the animation starts slow, speeds up, and then goes slow again. So that's a combination of acceleration and deceleration, hence the name smooth, because you have a gradual adjustment into and out of the keyframe. It's not an abrupt change like the linear keyframes. The last type I'll be talking about is constant, and in this case there is no interpolation. Once you hit the time of the keyframe, it changes instantaneously. This is like teleporting, for example. One moment you're at one location and the next you are somewhere else. I hope that those examples made some sense to you guys. The more you experiment and the more that you use these in practice, the more you'll understand them. But it is important to understand exactly why you should choose which kind of keyframe, and another thing to keep in mind is that these keyframes are generally a starting point. You may start with a smooth keyframe, but what you should do in many cases is build off of it. And that's where the graph editor comes in. It allows you to tweak your keyframes and get a stylized motion right to your likings.